Hello everybody, hope you're doing very well and welcome back to another cryptocurrency technical analysis, where in today's video I'm going to be going over Bitcoin, Ontology and Ontology Gas, the big mover of the day. So I hope that you enjoyed this video and let's crack on here with Bitcoin. So yeah, Bitcoin to be honest is the slowest of the three, definitely, still within this sideways range, and this range for me really stems from around 3,700 up to 3,950 more or less. That if we take a look at how long we've been in this range from our pump up really at the start of December, okay, and highlighting this consolidation that we've obviously originally, you know, come up above it, held it as support for it briefly, losing it, resistance, coming back into it, above, support, breaking down, resistance, breaking through, back into it, you know, back and through within this, you know, this is a really, really important zone that we are in. Okay, price is obviously attracted to this and then likes to hang around within here, to be honest. So really over the last few weeks, you know, we've been moving very sideways. I've obviously labeled this as coming down in the for wave one, then an ABC in the two. And I still do expect this to come down for the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the three. Obviously here, wave three is shorter than wave one, so wave five is going to be shorter than wave three. Okay, so that obviously would leave us, if this plays out, looking at around wave five to around 3,300. Okay, wave two does not have to be in though. Okay, so that's important to realize that we could get an extended correction in here. It doesn't have to be the ABC that I've got labeled here. If we continue to move on sideways within here, okay, we could start looking at some sort of WXY coming on, okay? But I'm still looking at this as we speak as the 1-2, okay? And I've got no reason to think otherwise. You know, only that this, obviously, you can see, I'm not going to zoom in too much, but you can see a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? Then coming up for an AB, possible C coming up in the 2. But I've not really been trading this on a short-term time frame. This is still my count from a bigger-term time frame, looking at this overall, okay? So I'm not scalping these ranges on Bitcoin, okay? I'm not scalping Bitcoin because I'm too mainly because I'm too busy, and secondly, just, yeah, it's too small of a range when I'm trading altcoins, okay? I've had much more fun trading altcoins. But this is important and just a bigger view of Bitcoin. I'm going to be going over my overall count, as I said in last video, my overall big term Elliott wave count for you all this week some point. I'm thinking I'll do the video Friday or Saturday, to be honest. I'll record it Friday or Saturday and then upload it. But it's going to be a good one because the overall Elliott wave count is very, very impressive, if I say so myself. So I hope that you enjoyed that. But yeah, Bitcoin obviously still within this range. There's nothing, you're not really going to be need to be looking at swing plays within this range. I'm still, you know, seeing the possibility of up to 4,000. Or if we, you know, if this turns into an extended correction, we get another leg up, for example. And then we still could potentially get another two coming up here. Obviously, if we look at, you know, potential areas where we could, you know, see this of the two. Obviously, we've already hit the 0.5. The 618 is still in play, which is obviously sat around golden pocket up to basically 4,000. Let's just say 4,000. Okay, golden pocket 3,978 to 3,996. Okay, so 4,000 basically. Okay, so that's an important level for me that I'm still aware of and trading off of. But yeah, stars of the show, let's go over Ontology with obviously an absolutely crazy move up today. I sold this one a little bit too early, if I'm honest, but it was still a decent trade. You can't complain. Trade a gain is a gain. But obviously what we see here is, you know, this is what I find funny, that I did not realize this news. And now I've set an alert to get alerted by every single Binance alert that they give off. So I'll be aware of this in the future. But when it started pumping, I was not aware of this trading giveaway, okay? So they were doing a trading giveaway, which is, you know, the reason, to be honest, for the pump. But what's really nice is that I was buying in on this anyway because of the bullish divergences that we were getting. One, it was totally oversold. You just see how, you know, just continuously coming down. And then the first time we come down again and we do form bullish divergences. Okay, so let's zoom in here on the 4 hour and I'll show you what I mean by this. So the price comes here down, for it forms a lower low. Okay, so price forms a lower low, and then you're seeing here on the divergence of the RSI, bullish divergences on RSI, okay, bullish divergences on the MACD lines themselves and the histogram with the same low. Okay, so that's bullish divergences in itself, more of a natural bullish divergence, but a bullish divergence nevertheless. Okay, so that's where we'd saw them, and then across the MACD lines, histogram slightly, but also the RSI. Okay, so there was bullish divergences enough to place a buy. Okay, so you just can buy with your, you know, your stop loss below your entry. And you know, this is where my original buy was, and I sold it, so yeah, way too early, but I sold it on this resistance, which obviously I'd highlighted as this old support, okay, old support that flips into resistance, okay. This old support obviously had been acting as resistance here prior, but then obviously we came up, held it as resistance, I sold on the resistance, and then we came back down, okay? And this was where, let's zoom into the 15 minute, I'll show you what went on here. Okay, so this was this morning. This news came out at about 8:15. Okay, so you see here around here, 8:15. Okay, this is a bit, you know, obviously you get the pump straight away and then you come back down. I wasn't aware of the news at all at this point. And if I had read this, I would have continued to buy in. So it was a little bit frustrating that I did not buy in on this retracement, because this is a retracement I would have bought if I was aware of the news as well, because this is, you know, always get some sort of pumps with these Binance giveaways. People love the giveaways. Okay, so I missed on this original, you know, come down, and I didn't buy the, but didn't buy the dip. Okay, didn't buy this dip, but I did buy this old resistance that flipped into support. So we broke through the resistance, we came back down and held it as support. Okay, and this was a game for me where I take out my Fibonacci extensions, and they actually lined up very nicely. So these red lines are the resistance lines. Let's zoom out here back on the daily and just remove this. Okay, no, 4 hours is going to be a lot nicer to explain what's going on here. Okay, so then you start trading it up to the next horizontal resistances, where you can see here the horizontal resistances that I have added. This is where we flip. So you can see that we break through. Okay, even it shows on the 4 hour, which is nice for me. So we break through, then you hold it as, so you break through resistance, hold that resistance, then flips into support, and you move up again. Okay, where to the next levels were obviously sat around here at 66 cents, and then obviously finally 78 cents. There was another wick above this, but I was out of this by here. Okay, but in total, this was from where my exit to, you know, another 12%, which would have obviously been very nice. But, you know, you have to think, in trading, to consistently sell tops like this is very, 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 very difficult and kind of unrealistic to expect. I mean, when you see this pumping up, you'd be very unlikely to expect to just go straight through this whole pocket of resistance. But obviously, price did do it. But yeah, that's just one of the things in trading. You're never going to consistently nail the exact tops and moves. And I was happy with this trade. But I would have been more happy if I was aware of this, because yeah, now I have definitely put on my alerts every single time, so I'll be aware. Although yeah, as you all know, I don't trade news, but these sort of giveaways, when they're first announced, like majority of the time, always cause an initial pump. The last one that I traded off this was when they done their Binance giveaway. I remember that, and I traded that off of the news, and it was so profitable just from their trading competition. And I think it was when they announced as well, they Binance announced that they were doing like 40% on their referrals, and yeah, that caused a massive pump as well. And I remember trading that all the day, and it was very enjoyable. And I forgot to alert myself. So yeah, this is what I'd recommend everybody to do. Come along to their Twitter account. I'll show you all what to do. Because it's so useful, and I have literally just done it today. So what we're going to see here is Binance, come across to Binance, and what you want to do is turn on mobile notifications. So you're going to get alerted that every time they do a tweet, obviously the majority of their ones I don't care about, okay, to be honest, but this is the one that I wish I was kind of alerted to. And because I'd have, because, well, I mean, the trade for me was still decent, but obviously I would have been buying this dip, okay? Because when you see on the 15 minute, that was the initial pump, okay? So you obviously had the initial pump. Well, I'll try and line this up a little bit better for you. You have the initial pump and you come down very, very, very nicely to the 786 Fibonacci level, which also was this old resistance flipping into support. But for me, that was the trade when I was out closing at this resistance. I wasn't looking to buy back. But if I was aware of the news, I would have bought the dip. But obviously I got in a little bit higher, so the trade was still very nice in the end. But yeah, that's just a little tip for you all of making sure that Binance alerts are set if you want to trade those breaks that can occasionally happen. Okay, so now I said I was going to go over ontology for you all. Ontology, obviously, I think this is like all follows because of the, you know, the ontology gas. Obviously, a lot of attraction to that. And then generally, you're going to get attraction to ontology, the parent of coin of it, I guess. And also Neo as well, getting us, you know, nice moves as well today. Obviously, they've retraced down a little bit now, but you can still see, obviously, here we are at 12 o'clock. Okay, so slightly later, but obviously, you have to remember that ontology gas. Okay, so ontology gas got its main pump at around 11:15. Okay, ontology getting its main pump up around, you know, slightly later. So obviously you get a very big pump up on ontology gas. Slightly later, you get the, you know, the ontology move up. So this is just something to like be aware of, like the family of coins. As I like to say, it's just like, don't know if you know if this is an official term, but like the family of coins. So generally, if you're going to see like ontology gas pump, you're going to see ontology pump, you know, the family as well, like Icon and WAN coin. I hope I'm saying this right, WAN. you know, these coins, like where they're in sort of a family together, that they're very interconnected. So WAN and also WAN chain, that was the one, WAN chain, and obviously Icon, they're like in a family together, and Ion as well. There's like you could just Google like the brands, and they're all like associated with each other. So this is just something to keep aware, you know, like an eye on that after one pumps, and you can generally expect this other one to follow. With it, might be in the same day or might be a day later, but they like to do that. Oh, Komodo is just like crazy with its pumps. This is like still ongoing, but yeah, the Komodo is like a really, really cool coin to trade, by the way. Or not so much trade, but just accumulate a Komodo when it goes sideways, because a pump always comes with this coin. Honestly, the pumps are unreal with this coin, that it just moves sideways, it pumps. Obviously it's given back a lot of the move, but it just goes. The coin goes. None of this is financial advice, so don't just randomly accumulate a Komodo if you don't know what you're doing. But if you do, and then it's a good coin to accumulate on these sideways regions. But yeah, and that's that was a quick rundown of Bitcoin. I actually have a meeting now at 7 o'clock, so I'm gonna have to wrap this up. Obviously 3 minutes to go until this web meeting. But yeah, it's gonna be cool. But yeah, basically for an overview of what I've went over today, like, yeah, really put your trading alerts on for Binance. Very recommended. But you could have, yeah, as you saw today, I wasn't aware of this news, and I obviously profited from just technical analysis. But, you know, having the knowledge of there's a giveaway is definitely beneficial to, you know, tell you buy the dip. but yeah, that's one little tip. And obviously on Bitcoin, I'm still expecting this to come down for the wave three, but the possibility that wave two is still on in an extended correction. Okay. And I will be covering the overall Elliott wave count in more detail for you all later this week. I don't think it's going to be tomorrow because I'm stacked tomorrow. But I'm hoping Thursday or Friday or Saturday, I'll get the video recorded for you all. So there's that to look forward to as well, and I'm excited to bring you all it. So yeah, thank you everybody for watching this video. I hope you've enjoyed. A bit of a fast-paced video. I can sometimes feel myself when I'm like really fast-paced, and I'm so aware of what the time is, so I have to like wrap it up and get through the content quite quick. But I like bringing you the videos nevertheless, so I hope that you've enjoyed this. And again, thank you so much for the support, everybody. The comments from obviously me announcing yesterday at the brand, which I'm so excited about, by the way. Like, this is going to be the place to come to learn technical analysis. I'm telling you, it's going to be the best place to learn technical analysis, I know. So I'm so excited to bring it off, start it all up. But obviously, yeah, just a really big thank you, everybody, for all the comments. You know, you've all done a lot of really just like so like supportive comments, really, really nice. So I'm looking forward to getting it all started and helping you all out. It's going to be great. It really is. So yeah, just a thank you again. And I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Thank you so much, everybody, and cheers. Thank you. Good night.